What are the key features of Accounts Payable, or AP, in NetSuite, and how does it work? In this video, we'll walk through the main transactions and records involved in NetSuite's AP, paying special attention to the connections between transactions. Let's get started. Before we get too deep into the transactions of AP, first, we need an idea of setting this up in your NetSuite account. In order to use Accounts Payable in NetSuite, you'll need to enable the AP feature, which you can find under the Basic Features section of the Accounting tab in Enable Features. While you're on this page, you'll need to make sure the Accounting feature has also been turned on in order for all the financial accounts connected with AP to be set up. Next, you'll need to get your vendor records set up. Vendor records are key because they contain all the essential information you need to track regarding your vendors, including things like their contact information, financial information, and any open transactions you have with them. You can set up vendor records manually by navigating to Lists, Relationships, Vendors, New. Alternatively, you could do a CSV import to import lists of vendors from a legacy system into NetSuite. Once your account is set up with the accounting and AP features, and once you have your vendor records in order, you're ready to start the AP transaction process. We'll start with purchase orders. Purchase orders, or POs, initiate NetSuite's AP workflow. Essentially, the PO is where you outline exactly what you need and which vendor you will be purchasing from. This foundational step sets the framework for the AP cycle. And because the purchase order is just an internal document used for tracking and managing purchase requirements, it has no GL impact. After you send your vendor the PO and they provide the goods or services, your vendor will then send you their bill. Vendor bills formalize your financial liability in NetSuite's AP cycle. A vendor bill, or just bill, outlines the accrued charges for rendered goods or services. Because of the connection between the AP transactions in NetSuite, you can generate a bill by selecting the Bill button at the top of the PO. At this point, NetSuite will credit your accounts payable account, creating a liability. Next, once you've actually paid your vendor, you'll need to record that payment in NetSuite. This brings us into the settlement phase of the AP process. To enter a payment, you would navigate to the Bill Payments page. Through this interface, you can record payments and associate them with the correct vendor bills. Bill payments are also connected to previous AP transactions. What this means then is that you could also record a vendor payment by selecting the Make Payment button on a bill. After you record a payment, your AP account will be debited to cancel out the liability, and your cash account will be credited to decrease the amount of cash you have. And that's accounts payable in NetSuite. From purchase orders and vendor bills to bill payments, NetSuite helps you through the entire AP workflow. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at SuiteRep.com.